Well, this is very strange because it again confuses two questions. I'm aware of the existence in South Korea of Christian associations against the cults, and they try to list which groups are cult and heretic. Quite strangely, the leader of one such South Korean associations was invited to the conference we attended in Hong Kong as part of the CCP delegation, which is very interesting, because why a Christian should come with the CCP. But anyway, as I say, that's in a free democratic society, it's perfectly free. You can establish an association and call heretic whatever you want. If you don't physically assault the heretic or propose to burn them, these associations are free. It's part of freedom of religion that you are free to call heretic the people you don't agree with. It's a free society. If you don't propose to kill them or to discriminate against them, and that's exactly the point. One thing is whether the Church of Almighty God is orthodox or heretic. That's a theological debate. The theologians can discuss in their universities. But another one is whether those who escaped China and came to Korea as members of Church of Almighty God should be granted refugee status. For me, the question is obvious. They should be granted refugee status because that matter is not a matter the Korean law or the Italian law or the American law can decide independently. These countries are bound by international conventions. They are part of international conventions on refugees, and they are part of the United Nations, which has issued clear guidelines. And there are some very clear points in these guidelines, but two are very important. In the guidelines on religious-based refugee claims, it's clearly written that religion should be broadly interpreted and should include new religion, which evangelicals normally call heretic, but that is not important for the United Nations and international law. New, even atheism should be constructed as a religion, according to the United Nations. So any religious belief is protected. Doesn't matter whether somebody regards it as strange, as unorthodox, as heretic. Every religious belief is protected. And the second point, very important, is the applicant for refugee status should not prove he or she has been individually persecuted. It's enough to prove that his or her religion is persecuted, so that he has what the documents call a fear of being persecuted. Now, that a believer of the Church of Almighty God in China has a fear of being persecuted should be obvious. And that's stated not by the Church of Almighty God only, it's stated by CCP. When CCP says we will eradicate the Church of Almighty God like a tumor, if I'm a member of the Church of Almighty God, do I have a fear of being persecuted when I hear this statement? The answer is obvious. But also, the legal system is clear. Article 300 of the Chinese Criminal Code, if you are active in a CNGAO, you go to jail. There is a list of CNGAO. First list was established in 1995, then again in 2000 and on and on. Church of Almighty God is in the list and has been in all the lists since 1995. So what is the position of the Chinese law, not even of the Chinese practice? The Chinese law says if you are active in the Church of Almighty God, you go to jail. So the persecution is inscribed in the law. And so it should be crystal clear that if you are a member of the Church of Almighty, a real member, of the Church of Almighty God in China, you have a fear of persecution. So it doesn't matter whether you have been individually persecuted. It doesn't matter whether other Christians in Korea believe you are heretic. You are part of a religious group, which as a group is persecuted. So you are entitled to refugee status. To conclude otherwise means to be guilty of a gross violation of the United Nations indication on religion-based refugee claims. And it is so strange and scandalous that we can only believe that this is happening because of political pressure from China, because otherwise the violation of international humanitarian law is blatant in this case.